NBC2 News at 6.
I know everything is cost, but at somebody's life, I mean, how many tragedies do we have before something's actually done?
Cape Coral community demanding change as the Lee County School District meets about safety at bus stops. It comes 1 week after Layla Aiken was hit and killed by a truck. Good evening, I'm Kelly Burns.
And I'm Peter Bush. Police are still looking for the driver of that truck. Meanwhile, NBC2's Emilia Fabiano talked to neighbors taking matters into their own hands to protect our kids. She is live in Cape Coral tonight.
People certainly aren't waiting for the school district or the city of Cape Coral to make changes. They're doing it themselves. Now, for those of you who live in Cape Coral, you may be familiar with street corners like these. You'll notice there are no sidewalks here, very minimal lighting. It's also a bus stop at this street corner, which is why these neighbors decided to put these benches in for students after Layla Aiken's death.
Oh, nobody would know that there's students that stand here waiting for their bus every morning.
So Melissa Scholak and her family took on the task to fix that, especially after hearing how Layla Aiken died.
It'll be out here for them to know, hey, this is for you. Please have a seat, feel safe, do whatever.
Families with students out at this bus stop say they appreciate the effort.
That's an awesome first start.
But many want more.
But I would definitely like for the school district to get involved and make changes.
The Lee County School Board added the topic to an already existing safety meeting with the sheriff's office this morning, the first public meeting they've had since Layla's death. They talked about bus stop safety for all of 15 or so minutes.
We're very concerned about the path that's traveled to the bus stop.
It's a multifaceted problem that's going to require multifaceted solutions.
It's also a problem that covers a lot of area, nearly 7,000 bus stops in the county, according to the school district. They sent NBC2 this checklist they currently use to choose bus stops, a combo of mandatory and preferred features like sidewalks.
What we would like to see moving forward is working with our municipalities to be able to establish some more permanent bus stops.
How this will be worked on was not addressed in detail yet, but people like Scholak,
I'm hoping to see something come of it.
Are ready for it now.
I know everything is cost, but at somebody's life, I mean, how many tragedies do we have before something's actually done?
Superintendent Adkins also told NBC2 this morning that their safety and security director is at the Cape Coral City Council meeting tonight. They are also working to put together a public meeting strictly about safety at school bus stops. Count on NBC2 to let you know if and when that will happen. Reporting live in Cape Coral, Emilia Fabiano, NBC2.